traditional and then a slightly healthier variation on that. So the base for both starts with apples. I had 5 and I peeled and chopped them up into little squares. And I preheated the oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So I just split the apples in half to make both of the fillings. And for the healthier filling, it's going to start with 1 tablespoon of cinnamon, 1/2 tablespoon of pumpkin pie spice, 1/2 tablespoon of nutmeg, 1/2 tablespoon of vanilla, 1 tablespoon of flour, and a tablespoon of applesauce. I only had strawberry flavored applesauce, so that's what I used. And you're just gonna mix that together, and then that is the filling that we'll then put into a baking dish. And we'll set that aside as we make the filling for the traditional one. So for this one, we're gonna put in 1.5 teaspoons of sugar. Teaspoon of cinnamon, and then about 1/2 teaspoon of some lemon juice, and we're just gonna stir that all together, and that's the filling for the traditional apple crisp. And we're also just gonna put that into a separate little baking dish, and then we're going to put both of these into the oven that's already been preheated to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and cook them for 20 minutes. While the fillings are cooking, we can then start on the toppings for both of the apple crisps. And so we're gonna start with the healthier variation, and we are gonna use oats as the main base. So it's gonna be about 1/2 cup of oats, and then about 1/2 cup of flour. I use gluten-free, but you can use any flour for this. We are then going to add about 1 tablespoon of coconut oil. You're gonna want it kind of melted. And 1 tablespoon of molasses, or you could use honey or maple syrup. And then just mix it together, and that is the finished topping. So the traditional topping, you're gonna use 1/2 cup of brown sugar mixed with 1/4 cup of oats and 1/4 cup of flour. Again, you can use any flour. And then we're going to mix this with 4 tablespoons of cubed butter. So I put this all in a mini food processor to chop it all together, but you could use a knife and chop the butter into the mixture by hand. The oats won't be chopped up as finely as they would be from using a food processor the way I did, but it still works if you do it by hand. So here are the 2 fillings after they've been pulled out of the oven. They're both ready to have the toppings put on it, so you just sprinkle the toppings all around it so the healthier one is on, and then we just put on the topping for the traditional apple pie. The traditional one's a lot more buttery of a topping, a lot more oily, but both toppings are on, and then we will put both of them back into the oven. And they will cook still on 350 degrees and cook for about another 25 minutes. And then once those are done cooking, they are all set and can be enjoyed. You could top them with ice cream or with whipped cream if you wanted to, or you could just eat them plain. They were both delicious. The traditional one is more sweet and more fatty, and the healthier one is enjoy.